I'm going to preach about Chronos and Kairos. Everybody say Chronos. Everybody say Kairos. There are actually three Greek words that describe the word times. For us, time is just time, but in the Greek, it's very specific. First of all, is the word Chronos. Okay. Now, in 1 Chronicles chapter 12 and verse 32, the Bible says, of the sons of Issachar, who had understanding of the times and season. Now, first of all, I pray that all of us would have the Issachar anointing to know the times and the season for our life, our family, our church, and our nation. And secondly, the sons of Issachar also know what they ought to do. It's very important for us to know how to respond to the times and the seasons of God in our life, in our nation. And secondly, to know what we ought to do. If you study the Bible, you probably realize that God is a God of plan and purpose. He's a great strategist, but He's also a God of timing. Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1 says, there is a time and a season under every event on earth. And in verse 11 it says, in His time He makes all things beautiful. Dalam masa dan musim Tuhan, semua akan menjadi indah. Yang tidak indah akan menjadi indah. Yang tidak sempurna akan menjadi sempurna. Yang tidak benar akan menjadi benar. Senang untuk kebar dalam bahasa. Amen. I picked it up 2 years ago. I forced myself to learn to speak Bahasa, preach in Bahasa, and I listened from the internet Bahasa in Indonesia Bible that you can download and listen every day. Why did I say that and emphasize that? Because the new generation of people in Malaysia do not speak English, do not understand English. How do we preach to them if we do not know Bahasa? You're still alive, you're still breathing. Learn Bahasa. Turn to your neighbors and learn Bahasa. Okay, so it's very important for us to know the times and the season we are living in Malaysia. Amen? Now, Jesus gave a classic example of timing in John 11. Here was the good friend, and Martha, Mary, and Lazarus. And Jesus, every time He comes to Bethany, He will stay with this family. This family must be very special. There's a special bond, there's a special love. And one day, Jesus heard Lazarus was sick. He didn't come, drop by and visit him. It's okay. Maybe he's busy in the ministry. Then he heard Lazarus died and had funeral. He didn't attend. That made him a very bad pastor. I wondered some people in the church would have left, right? If such a pastor exists. Hey, your good friend Lazarus died. He didn't come for the funeral. Never mind. 4 days later, Jesus turned up. Martha said, yeah, stinks already. Like, you come so late. But to God, that was precise timing. Jesus, listen to this. Jesus was not moved by needs. He was moved by the timing of God. So you need to understand what is Chronos, what is Kairos, what's Pleroma, to move according to the timing of God in our life. What is Chronos? Firstly, Chronos is simply time in succession. This is where we get the word chronological order. It means second, hour, day, month, years. That's a chronological order. All right? Mark 1:15 says, the time, the chronos, is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Now, there are a lot of words in the English Bible written times, but you need to find out whether it refers to chronos, kairos, or pleroma. All right? Let's look at the second word, kairos. Now, I'm sure you have heard the word kairos many times. But the word kairos means appointed time, window of opportunity. Acts 3:19 says, repent therefore and be converted. Then your sin may be blotted out, so that times, the word times that is kairos, times of refreshing or revival may come from the presence of the Lord. And then the third word, pleroma. As you look at the word pleroma, I just want to mention about this book. This book, Times and Season, is a great book. If you have not got a copy, get a copy. And one of the topics here is called The Midnight Hour. And what I'm teaching this morning is from this book also, all right? So the third word is called pleroma. Everybody say pleroma. It means fullness of time or maturity of time. In Galatians 4:4, it says, when the fullness or pleroma of time has come, God sent forth His Son, Jesus. Now, many people wonder whether Malaysia is on its way for doom and gloom. I remember we sent my son Asher 2 months ago. That was August, and we bought the US currency 3.8. And now it's almost 4.3. And quite recently, my son called up and said, Dad, what's happening to our Malaysian ringgit? He was anxious and nervous because he's just doing his first year. He got 3 more years to go, you understand? So I knew what he was saying. I said, Asher, relax, man, relax. Don't worry. You focus on your study. You don't worry about the finance, all right? I said, God has provided. God will provide. God spoke that you will go to US to study. He will take care of everything. You just relax, just focus. Amen. Whether US dollar to ringgit is 4.3 or 5, Jehovah Jireh is still on the throne. He is my provider and your provider. That's why you can thank God. You thank God not because our ringgit is going down. You thank God because you have a living Savior. You have Jehovah Jireh. You have El Shaddai that is always on the throne. And there is no economic recession in the treasury of heaven. Hallelujah. Turn to the one and say, rejoice. You know, every corner you go, every Malaysian you meet, I hope non-Christian, all the negatives, all the bad things, all the gloom. I think the worst has happened in Malaysia. There could not be anything worse. MH370, MH17, 2.6 billion, 1MD, 1F, whatever. But I want to tell you something. Jesus is still on the throne. God the Father is still on the throne. I want to encourage you, church, when Nebuchadnezzar was on the throne, when Pharaoh was on the throne, Jesus was not nervous. So I wanted to see from the background of our nation with the message this morning. It's just like the time of Israel in Exodus 2. The Bible says when the people of God were oppressed by Pharaoh, they cry out to God. Mereka berseru kepada Tuhan, kepada Allah. They cry out to God. Do you know what the Bible says? God heard their cry. God heard their cry, but there was a timing. God hasn't delivered them, but God heard their cry. I believe that's what's happening in Malaysia. God hear the cry of all the Malaysian Christians who have fasted, who have prayed, who have cried for the nation. It's not wasted. We will see the deliverance and the salvation. Just wait for the timing. I tell you, something good is happening in Malaysia, just that you don't know. Never mind the ringgit is dropping. Never mind the oil and all those things. I tell you what, something. God is moving in the BM speaking church in Sabah, Sarawak, in Malaysia. I just came back from Tawau, an Anglican church that had 3,000 members. We spoke in the BM service evangelistic meeting and the Chinese evangelist meeting. We had 35 first-time salvation on a weekend. That is pretty good. Can you imagine every church have 35 salvation every week? I tell you, something is happening. Earlier this May, we had an open-air meeting at Merdeka Square. I shared that the last time I was here. First time in the history, Merdeka Square in KK for an evangelistic meeting. I preached on the first night, BM speaking, salvation. I never seen people run. This is the first time. They usually walk to the altar call. This one, they run to the altar call to receive Jesus. Something is happening in Malaysia. You see, Malaysia is, God is not concerned whether a ringgit is 4.3 or 5. God is concerned for the salvation of the mankind, including the politicians and those, whoever they are, wherever they are. Hallelujah. That's most important. Do you know something? When the share market is down, the gospel market is up. More people come to Jesus through hard times than through good times. So we can thank God. Like the church in SIB is growing. SMCC is growing. So it's a good sign. Hallelujah. We are on the winning side, my dear. It's not all doom and gloom for Malaysia. The best is yet to come. Listen to this song that the Lord gave me. a prophetic song, I believe, for the nation. And it's found in my CD. Get this copy, and also the song From Heavens Flows Down Blessing and many other great songs. I tell you, this CD is the best. I've listened for months. I never get tired. It helps you to pray and worship God. If you love to pray and worship God, get this CD. Get two copies, maybe three. One for a house, one for the kitchen, one for the car. Really, you'll be blessed. Believe me, all right? Let's hear this Malaysian song that the Lord gave. It's a prophetic song. As you hear this, lift your heart and just pray for Malaysia. The best is yet to come for Malaysia. You believe that? Thank you. Thank you, media team.
Yeah.
Amen. Let's just lift our hands and pray for Malaysia right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, we declare that Malaysia shall be safe. We declare Malaysia will see the glory of God, will see the revival of God. We declare, Lord, that the salvation will come upon our land, upon our shore, from the north to the south, from the east to the west. Sabah, Sarawak, the Borneo Islands will be impacted with the gospel of the kingdom, that no man, no devil able to stop this move of God. Father, we know the best is yet to come. We pray for the wisdom upon the cabinet, upon Najib and all the leaders who are making the decision to help Malaysia to turn around. Father, grant them wisdom from on high. Lord, we bless them. We ask, Lord, they too will receive salvation, that you speak to them in dreams and vision and supernatural visitation. Lord, that many will bow their knees and declare that Jesus is Lord. We thank you, Father, Lord, that this nation shall be a blessing to the nations of the world, Father, that many will come and see what God is doing in our midst, Father. We ask, Lord, that you heal our economy. Let the ringgit be strengthened back to 3.8, Father, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, that your kingdom come and your will be done in Malaysia. In Jesus' name, and if you believe, shout, Amen. Give Jesus a wonderful clap. Oh, glory to God. I feel the anointing and the presence as I pray for Malaysia. I want to tell you something. God loves Malaysia. Believe me. How many of you believe God loves you? Well, if God loves you, God definitely loves Malaysia, right? Hallelujah. Do you know, I had the opportunity to immigrate to Canada and Australia, but I choose to be in Malaysia because Malaysia is the best country. Hallelujah. Believe me, I've been to 49 nations. I still agree and vote Malaysia is the best. Malaysia truly Asia. Hallelujah. Whew. Okay. Sorry. I think the tourist department must pay me for advertising Malaysia. All right. Let's continue our Chronos and Kairos. Everybody say Kairos. Let's look at the life of Joseph. You see, many times we don't understand that actually our suffering, our bitter experiences, and our faithfulness, and everything that we do in this life prepare us for greater things. Amen? And some of us may be sowing and sowing and giving and giving, just like Hannah. She was praying year by year to the temple. She was barren, but she was believing God for a breakthrough. She was praying year by year, and no answer. Some of you may be in that situation. Year by year, praying for a breakthrough, for a miracle. No answer. But don't give up. Don't give up. No more delay. God's about to move. And it actually prepare you. This is what you do in a Chronos. God's prepare you for your Kairos. You know, one day, Hannah had a breakthrough. God remembered Hannah and she conceived. I believe God remembers you. God remembers your prayer. God remembers your sacrifice. God remembers your givings. Just like Cornelius in Acts 10, he was giving. He was praying as if nothing is happening. He was going through the Chronos. He was doing what was required, praying and giving. One day, angel of God appeared to him. Cornelius, your prayer and your alms has ascended to heaven as a memorial. God records all our good deeds, all our givings. And one day, we will see the breakthrough. We'll see the salvation. We'll see the miracle. Your times are in God's hand. Your future is in God's hand. Psalm 31, verse 15. Your times are in God's hand. Your future is in God's hand. Your children's education overseas is God's hand. Believe for great things and greater things ahead. Amen. So don't give up. Don't be discouraged. Your Kairos, your Chronos, actually work out, prepare you for the Kairos that is to come. Joseph went through so much suffering. He was thrown in the pit, he was sold in the Potiphar's house, and he was sent to prison. From 17 years old, he had a prophetic dream of greatness, and now he was going through the pit, he was going to the prison, not because he sinned. He was walking righteous before God. God was preparing him for greater things. He was going through the Chronos of life. The Chronos of life could be up and down. The Chronos of life could be situation in our life that we don't understand what happened. Later, I'll share with you my testimony when we sent our son to States, what happened. It's just mind-boggling. But one thing for sure, God prepared a Kairos. What is Kairos? Kairos is this window of opportunity, this open door, this divine connection. Pastor Chi was sharing with me just before the first service, second service at SMCC. He was sharing how the Lord prompted his heart to buy the property, the shop lot near SSMC church there. You know, he said many times he has passed by. He has passed by that place many, many times, but nothing clicked. You see, it was Chronos. He just passed by. But one day, God turned the Chronos into Kairos. He saw that building and said, hey, we should buy it. And it's amazing when he received that inspiration, he received that divine thought, or rather he downloaded from God. I just finished writing my book, Download from God. We're going to send it to you. You're going to give us a forward. You know, you just download that. You just receive from God. You spoke into it and you met the businessman and he just sponsored the whole project. You see, just the Chronos hits the Kairos, the open door, that divine connection that is so powerful that prepare you for the fullness, the miracle, the pleroma. I was sharing about how divine connection is so important. Last year, October, a good friend of mine, Pastor Lito from Philippines, invited me to speak just one session of 30 minutes to a pastor's fellowship. And it was on the midweek on Thursday. And I just came back from Monday, and then Friday I'll be flying off. So I only had Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And he invited me for that 3 days, which was very precious for me because it was time just to rest, recuperate, and get ready for the next trip. I say no to him straight away, but he kept on pleading with me. He said, Pastor Paul, I feel it's very important for you to come. I feel it's important for you to connect with this man of God, Pastor Don Lavelle from America, and also there's a pastor from South Korea coming. You come. As I bring before God, the Lord says, go. So I put down all my things and I went. I went with another pastor's friend, just on Tuesday, speak on Wednesday, come back on Thursday. Anyway, it was there that I met with Dr. Don Lavelle, a great man of God from America that has a big church in Corpus Christi, which we preached recently in August. We were in his church. It was a divine connection. What if I didn't go? What if I didn't respond to the Kairos? And it was also during that meeting, I met Pastor Yoon from South Korea, give him a prophetic word, and he's a Baptist. You know Baptist? They don't believe in tongues, they don't believe in prophecy, but it was well received. And do you know, this year, last month, October, first time in our life, we went to minister in South Korea. I've been praying for more than 20 years to go to South Korea. Heard so much about South Korea, wondered so much. Of course, we can just go for a visit, but that's not my intention. I want to go there to preach. So God opened the door, and first time in 25 years, we went to South Korea. Give Jesus a wonderful clap. So what I'm trying to say is, be faithful in your Chronos. Be faithful in your prayer, in your fasting, in your crying out to God, in your attendance, in your giving. Because the Chronos prepare you for the Kairos, the open door, the divine connection, the divine appointment. Somebody you meet that will change your life and destiny. Why did Joseph have to go to prison? Because he has to meet the cupbearer. He has to interpret the dream for the cupbearer. And the cupbearer had a dream that couldn't be interpreted. So he came along and interpreted the dream. You see, be faithful with the gift God gave you. You may just have one talent, one gift. That's all Joseph had, the gift to interpret dream. And he used it in the prison where he was also a prisoner. So whatever you are, use the gift God gave you. And don't despise anybody you meet. It can be a janitor or a senator. Don't despise. If you meet a janitor, he could be the key for you to go to the palace. So he interpreted the dream of the cupbearer. And he told the cupbearer, please get me out of prison. But it was not God's time. It was still Chronos. It was not Kairos. In Genesis 40, last verse, the Bible says the cupbearer forgot Joseph. And then in Genesis 41, verse 1, at the end of 2 full years, Pharaoh had a dream. Nobody could interpret. The cupbearer remembered there was Joseph in the prison. And within one day, Joseph was promoted from prison to palace. Within one day, from Chronos to Kairos, he came to the fullness where he was in the palace, receiving the pleroma, the breakthrough, the miracle, and the promotion that he needs. So it's very important what you do in Chronos, because it prepares you for Kairos and pleroma. How many of you ladies here, you have carry a baby before? Can I see you? How many of you mothers here? Wave your hand at me. Wow, quite a lot of mothers here. Wonderful. You understand this. You know, your Chronos is about the 9 months. You eat, you sleep, you work. You feel the pain, you feel the kick. You feel your stomach, your womb actually grows bigger and bigger, right? You are going through a Chronos. And you have to go through the Chronos in order for you to experience the Kairos. What's the Kairos? When your water bag bursts and your contraction begins, that's where Pastor Chiu comes in. Handy those days. You actually, your Chronos prepare you for your Kairos. Your Kairos has this window of opportunity. And every gynae will tell you that, hey, this is very important. Don't play. Huh? Your contraction, huh? The baby can die one and all. The mother can die one and all. There can be whatever. And it's very important. It's a transition. It's very important. And then finally, the baby come out. And you have this miracle baby in your hand. Wow, pleroma, the fullness of time. I was sharing the first service that Malaysia actually right now is going through a midnight hour. In Exodus 12, at midnight, the angel of death went through Egypt, killing all the firstborn. Firstborn of the Egyptian and the animal. But God's people were spared. It was judgment on Pharaoh and the Egyptian, but salvation and deliverance for God's people. I believe we are going through a midnight hour, a transition, a very scary, difficult time, a dark time. But I tell you what, God's light will shine. All right? It's found in this book, more about the timing of God. So get this copy. All right? So the next example I want to use is the life of a butterfly. You see, within all of us, there is an instinct, a sense of greatness, a sense of purpose, a desire, may I say. How many of you at some point have a desire to go to America? You have never been, but you'd like to someday. Can I see your hand? May the Lord grant the desires of your heart. How many of you have never experienced snow, touched snow, played with snow, and you'd like to have that experience someday? Can I see your hand? Oh, all of you have. Huh? Wow. Or you don't like snow, you don't like cold. Don't be shy. One last chance. How many of you would like to experience snow in your life? Father, take a picture in Jesus' name. You didn't put up your hand, you miss it. You put up your hand, receive that word. Okay, come back to our story. You see, this caterpillar that was created by God, just little wriggling things with so many legs. But there's something called instinct, something called a divine destiny put into this caterpillar. And can you imagine this caterpillar crawling among all his peers and among all his friends and all other animals? He says, you know something? One day I shall fly. One day I shall touch the sky. My wife can sing. I sing. I like to sing. You know the difference? Okay, doesn't matter if you don't, you know. Now, I can imagine this caterpillar crawling away. And all his well-meaning friends and those around say, hey, hello, caterpillar. You don't have wings. You're so bulky and so slow and you got only legs. You want to fly? Ha, ha, ha. You want to fly? I don't know, but sometimes I feel inside me, I know one day. One day will come. That day will come. And sure enough, as the caterpillar goes to Chronos, it goes to the time and the seasons that went through. And suddenly, within one day, he's transformed into a cocoon. I'm not sure whether the caterpillar was prepared for that, but it still has to go through. The cocoon was actually a Kairos moment. And some of you, I sense in my spirit this afternoon that you're going through this Kairos cocoon stage of your life and ministry and your walk, and you're just bundled up and things look like nothing is happening. Nothing is happening. God, where are you? Why is my prayer not answered? Why we haven't seen breakthrough? Why is the ringgit falling and you don't bother and my son is overseas studying? God, where are you? But do you know within the cocoon, even though you don't feel God is there, God is there. Even though you don't feel God is working out something, God is definitely working out something. Just like in Malaysia right now. We are in a cocoon stage. It seems like nothing is happening. Nothing good, right? The more we pray, the worse it becomes, right? Hey, that's a good sign, man. The more we pray, the worse it becomes. I tell you, it's scriptural. The more the children of Israel cry out in Exodus 2, the worse they were oppressed. So it's a good sign. We are very similar to the Bible. True. I mean, the more you pray, nothing happens, that's a bad sign. But the more you pray, the worse it becomes. Ah, that's a good sign. Because you're about to see a breakthrough. Yeah. It's always like that. Read the Bible. Amen. Don't pray somebody will die. Pray somebody will be safe. Hello. Daniel 2:21. God removes kings. God sets up kings. Leave it to God. I say leave it to God. God sets up king, God removes king. All God requires, we pray. Don't judge, we pray. So, we are at a cocoon stage. We are at a cocoon stage, but God was working on the caterpillar, putting the wings, putting the colors, putting the strength, putting the structure, putting the bones. Why? He's getting you ready for your next season. Say your next season. He's getting you ready for your next level. Say next level. A prophetic word, next season, next level, you are going to go through. You're going to go into as a church, individually and family. Next level, next season. That's why you're at a cocoon stage. And then suddenly the cocoon bursts open. And comes that beautiful butterfly flying with all the multicolors, with the sun shining and touching the clouds. See? It has come to pass. Let me illustrate how using my son's studying in America, illustrate the concept of Chronos, Kairos, and Pleroma. You see, at 17 years old, you probably know that it's Form 5, SPM. But my son did an American program. And you know the background of his story. At 2 months in the mother's womb, there was no heartbeat. He died. God raised him back. From 6 months to 9 months, the head was not growing. There's something wrong with the placenta. And you know, there could be so much complication. But when Asher, my son, was born, he was just a normal, perfect baby. I just marvel. And the best part is he looks like the father. Now, I didn't expect him to be a genius. We just thank God that he's just a normal kid. And then at 17 this year, he's supposed to finish his grade 12 American program in September. And while he was doing his grade 12, you wouldn't believe, he cut an album. He composed songs. He goes for music. He had a Christian band, the youngest. I don't know how he led them, but he led them. And all these older people submit to him. It's just amazing. And here comes this album. At 17, while studying grade 12, I don't know how he managed. He got all A's. He did very well, praise the Lord. And then he did a concert, lucky mind-boggling, and with this T-shirt. Do you know, I was so encouraging or discouraging. I said, actually, hold on. I think you better concentrate on your grade 12. You know, am I thinking, if you feel I got to repeat, I got to give up more money, you better pass. And go. So I was thinking, Asher, I think you better concentrate on your study. This album, this singing, all this concert. After you graduate, you know, you got all the time or holidays, you do it. But now I think you study. You know, my son, he got a very unique characteristic. I think he came from the mother. When he wants something, that's it, man. That's it. He wants something, he'll get it on. Don't know, somehow he got the grace and the favor on. Amazing. So I've seen it the last 17 years of his life. So I knew I cannot fight with him. I said, okay, I leave it in God's hand. But I didn't know that he prayed and asked God. Say he prayed and asked God. Parents, I want to share something powerful. Teach your children to pray and ask God. Teach your children to rely their faith on God, not on your prayers. Very important. They have to grow up to walk with God, not based on your faith and your prayer, on their own faith, on their own prayer. So, Asher, I didn't know, he quietly asked God. And then, this year, we were speaking in a conference together with Julius Subi in KK. And while at the conference, Julius Subi gave a prophecy to my son. Never met before, don't know anything, huh? Don't know he's studying America. You know, he prophesied he's going to go to America. He's going to marry in America. He's going to stay in America. Everything is going to fast forward. He's going to marry early, finish early, do things early. I was there. I hearing the prophecy. I said, wow, Lord, forgive me. This father lack of faith. Huh? But here is my son. So fast. In fact, I bought December ticket for him to go to Brunei and Miri with us, you know. That one had to burn already. Lah. But you see, he's finishing his grade 12 in September. How could he go this year? But amazingly, he finished in July. He was accepted by the university in June. And we went in August. Wow, so fast. You see, when the Chronos finishes and the Kairos open up, where could university accept you before you finish grade 12? And then here comes this product. Anyway, so we bought the ticket. Last minute, Korean airline, three of us. The cheapest you can find in the market. Transit 9 hours in Seoul. We were all excited, going to St. Asher, had a farewell, Pastor Chu prayed for us. And then when we check in to fly from Seoul to LA, my passport got visa, Asher's passport got visa, but my wife's passport got no visa. So she could not fly. You see, it was my mistake, my biggest mistake in life. I kept all the passport. She had the old visa, 10 years visa in the old passport. In a hurry, I took the 3 new passport, forget the old passport that my wife had, the US visa. So can you imagine, we are now in Seoul airport. She couldn't fly. And then we had these 5 big bags. Thank God for the mom who packed all these 5 big bags, supposed for 4 years for my son, but I think can last for 40 years. And all these 5 big bags, you know, mothers, any mothers here? If I were to pack, I think only 2 lah. She packed 5 anyway. And now she cannot fly. 2 of the bags were under her name. They took it out. My son was at the days. He said, Dad, this is 2 bags. All the 5 big bags are all his barang, all his things, none of us. So we began to negotiate with the people there. I said, please, you know, these bags belongs to my wife and it's all for a family. We are not outsiders. And then finally, when this lady, she's a supervisor, a Korean lady, she said, I understand, I got a son studying in America. Can you prove that 3 of you are family? I said, yes. We took out Asher's birth certificate. She took a picture and she let the 2 bags in. So me and Asher fly and we had to say goodbye to my wife. I was so sad to see her. She was so sad. And here was this silly mistake of mine. Forgot the passport with the visa. So I entered the plane. I could not forgive myself. Could you imagine? I could forgive those idiots who offended me and did wrong. Sorry, I mean brothers and sisters. But I couldn't forgive myself. Great preacher, huh? I was sitting down there in the plane, gloom and doom and sad. I was thinking, hitting myself. How could you make that mistake, silly Paul? I didn't say it, but it was in my mind. Then my son sitting next to me, he said to me, Dad, don't worry. God causes all things to work together for good. Well, I've been preaching to him the last 17 years. Now he's preaching back to me. And not only that, he quoted the right scripture and God spoke to me. Yalla, God, forgive me, forget it. Why should I be gloomy and discouraged? I said, preach, praise God. Devil, get thee behind me. It's over. And then he said something so prophetic. Dad, don't worry. Mom, ticket wasted. Never mind. We suspected mom will buy another new ticket to fly. So I was telling Asher, don't be surprised if you see mom again soon. So you know what Asher said? You know, he's so prophetic. He said, Dad, don't worry. All our ticket, when you go for ministry in America, sure cover one. Sure. I was thinking, wow, this boy, talk only you can. You don't have to believe God for the money. I have to believe, you know, you just talk only money come, talk only FA come, talk only go to America. Easy only. But I have to believe God. Anyway, I kept quiet. I kept in my heart what he said. So we went to States, and we flew into LA. We had a contact. He came for our conference. He didn't know us. I do not know them. He came for our conference last year. Then when he saw us, he offered us. He said, next time you come to States, we'll take care of you. We'll arrange meeting for you. We'll house you, feed you, travel, whatever, taken care. I said, sure. So we decided to fly to LA before we fly to Dallas. So here we are at the LA airport, landed. So immigration officer said, what are you here for? I'm sending my son to university. What do you do? I'm business. What do you sell? T-shirt, CD. True. I'm a businessman for Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm selling CD. Please get a copy. Huh? This is too, only 30 ringgit. Special promo. Asher's CD. Very good for the young people and the T-shirt, okay? It helped him to finish his study in America. Anyway, so no problem. He chopped. Then my son. Okay. Where is your I-20 form? What? I-20 form? But we use that to apply for the visa in Malaysia. Yes, but we need the I-20 form to process. You cannot enter without the I-20 form. Say faller. Die a lily. So I say, how? I say, you? Go down. Can I go with him? He said, no, you cannot go with him. You go down, take your bag, wait for him. And he sent him to what they call secondary screening. And by the way, I just discovered that people, students who go in without the I-20 form were deported. Because many came with a false visa and all those. It was a serious matter. I didn't know. Because we didn't know. First time, thank God. First time, only one son. Thank God I don't have to repeat all this. Anyway. Here we are with my five bags, like Pachu, like move house like that. These five giant bags, not the small one, the biggest one in town, you know. Those American size, five bags. I waited for my son, no sign of him. 1 hour passed, no sign. My friend waiting outside there to pick us. 1.5 hours, no sign. Wow, this time, become anxious. Turn the airport into prayer meeting. Korababa shakaraba soko. Kilaba. God, where are you, Jesus? Holy Spirit, help, man. My son is inside there. Kurabaraba. Why so long one? Kurabababa. Do you know when you go through that time, it's like eternity? It's very long. Even 5 minutes is very long. 1 hour, 45 minutes, 2 hours, no sign. Then the devil play tricks lah. You're going to go back with your son, man. How are you going to face SIB? How are you going to face your family? Malu, ni tell everybody go to America. Now cannot enter America. Korea, ba-ba-ba. Devil, get thee behind me in Jesus' name. My son, God says he will go to study in America. I believe sometimes you got to wage the warfare with the word and the promise of God. I said, devil, God say he sent my son to America. The prophet of God has spoken. God has opened the door. No man, no devil, no American immigration is going to stop him in Jesus' name. Don't tell them I pray this. Huh? Very sensitive, but that's what I prayed. 2.5 hours. Now I'm in a real dilemma. You know why? I have these five big bags with me. My friend, 2.5 hours waiting at the airport. I don't know whether he'll still be there. And I don't know anybody in LA beside him. And the phone cannot call. Do you know at the airport, you cannot call. You cannot WhatsApp. Lord, I'm torn now. Go out with him. Wait for my son. What if Asher comes out, didn't see me? He may panic. That's worse off. I think that's more precious. I think, never mind, I've missed lah. I tell you, that time was a real torment. I thought I was a great man of faith, man. Suddenly, when I was tested, I found I was a great man of powder. Not faith and power. I said, Lord, I really got no faith. I don't know how long this is going to go on. 2 hours, 45 minutes. It's like eternity, you know. But what can you do? Just pray in tongues. Lah. And finally, I saw my son coming down from the staircase. What joy unspeakable, and my tears rolled down. Because for you to come down means they let you in, you know. If not, they deport you. I tell you, Asher was so happy to see me. I asked him, what if you don't see me here and wait outside? He said, oh, Lord, Dad, I already had gone through so much. Don't want to go through. And do you know, true to his word, you know, we preach in Dr. Don's Level Church and some churches in LA. And all the offerings collected paid for all our effort. I forgot to tell you, my wife, very clever, get a credit card, buy a fresh new ticket, fly over, see us there. But all were paid if we still got extra money. When God speaks, when it comes Kairos, you will see the pleroma. Let's stand. Thank you, Jesus. I believe God speaks to us in a message like this. I don't know what you're going through. But if you're here this afternoon, you do not know Jesus, you've never received Jesus into your heart, and this is your Kairos, this is your window of opportunity, this is your golden opportunity. I want to give you this opportunity to receive Jesus. If you're here, I want to pray for you and with you. Just raise your hand. Is there somebody here? You want to receive Jesus for the first time? Thank you. Thank you, my dear. Anybody else? Thank you. Who else? Thank you. Who else? Two of you. Wow. Three. Anybody else? Whew, what a move. What? Anybody else, please? Anybody else you want to receive Jesus? Thank you. There's another one. Four. Whew, wow. Durian runto, man. Whew. Anybody else? Quickly. Show. Anybody else? Anybody else you want to receive Jesus? This side, this side, that side. Where else? Anybody else? This side. Balcony. Anybody else? Okay, we're going to play the song from Heaven Flows Down the Blessing. Those of you who put up your hand, would you just quickly come forward? And we want to pray for you to receive Jesus. The greatest things in your life is to receive Jesus. And as the song is sung, you still can come to receive Jesus if you're here. Those who put up your hand, would you just come, both of you? Don't be shy. That's the greatest things in your life. Jesus says, if you confess me before men, I'll confess you before God the Father.